Heads up, for accuracy, I'll be calling coronavirus SARS-CoV-2 throughout the video. Everything the body does on the inside, from head to toe, is done by proteins. These are the tools of the body. So they're clearly important, and they're being made on a regular basis with a very simple two-step process. This process will help you understand exactly how the vaccine works. This process takes place in the cells of our body. Step one, DNA. Our DNA houses the information to make every protein in our body. But here's the thing, our DNA ain't going anywhere. It sits inside the nucleus of the cell and it ain't moving. So in order for proteins to be made, something has to move that information from the nucleus and tell the cell how to make that protein. mRNA is what does that. mRNA is the second step. mRNA carries the information from the DNA and gives it to the cell so that it can make a specific protein. If it helps, the M in mRNA stands for messenger because they carry a message. So the two steps, DNA, mRNA, and boom, the result is a protein. Congratulations, you almost understand exactly how the vaccine works completely, absolutely, totally. Almost. So what happens when the person in the lab coat sticks the vaccine needle in your arm? If you haven't seen a picture of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, here it is. The most important piece of this virus is this part right here. Guess what this part is? It's a protein. The SARS-CoV-2 virus just so happens to have the same process as us when it comes to making protein. DNA, mRNA, protein. And this is what is given to us when we take the shot. The DNA or the mRNA of SARS-CoV-2's protein. Not the whole SARS-CoV-2 virus, but this part right here. This protein, it's called the S protein. So inside the vaccine is a tiny particle that carries the DNA or mRNA of the S protein. When we receive the needle, that particle goes into the blood, fuses with the cell, and releases the DNA or the mRNA of the S protein. Pfizer and Moderna, two vaccine companies, use the mRNA of the S protein for their vaccine. Johnson & Johnson and AstraZeneca use the DNA of the S protein. So what happens when the DNA or mRNA of the SARS-CoV-2 virus gets released? The body takes the same steps it does with our own DNA and mRNA. DNA, mRNA, protein. Except this time, that ain't our protein. The body recognizes that S protein as a foreign invader, and boom, the immune response that we're looking for takes place. If you watched that entire thing and that didn't help you at all, go ahead, dislike this video, drop a nasty comment, cuss me and my mom out. Nah, just kidding. I'm gonna get up out y'all way. Hope that helped.